Hi. This brief tutorial demonstrates how to set up your MacBook Pro to play high-definition sound. At the end of the video, if you enjoyed it, please hit the like button and subscribe buttons. In this clip, a USB connection is used to link a 2011 MacBook Pro to a Cambridge Audio DAC Magic 200M DAC. This device configuration is able to support 24-bit high-definition audio at 768 kHz. The MacBook Pro is playing songs from Amazon Music HD, which supports Ultra HD quality 24-bit at 192 kHz playback, despite the fact that the track quality of the song being played right now is 24-bit at 192 kHz. At the moment, it is being played in 16-bit at 44.1 kHz. This is, primarily because the device's capabilities were misidentified, as being limited to 24-bit at 44.1 kHz. Because of this misconfiguration, you will be unable to fully enjoy your high-definition audio and the capabilities of the connected device. Fortunately, the solution to this problem is simple on macOS. To get started, launch the macOS Audio MIDI Setup application. Select the audio device on which you want to play the high-definition audio from the menu on the left. Choose the bitrate and frequency you wish to play back your high-definition music at from the format drop-down menu. Choose the format that your source audit supports. For example, even though the device supports 768 kHz, I've chosen 192 kHz because that is the highest rate supported by Amazon Ultra HD Audio. If you resume a previously played or paused song, after making changes in audit MIDI setup, the changes may not be picked up correctly. In order for the music to play using the new settings, it is best to start playing it from the beginning. Now, Amazon Music will show that the audio is being played back at the appropriate sample rate. If your device has information about the incoming sample rate, it should also get automatically updated to reflect the changes you made in the macOS Audit MIDI setup application. It's worth noting that, when making this video as of January 2023, Amazon Music on macOS Ventura lacks the ability to dynamically change the device sample rate on the fly. Therefore, it's probably best if you choose a sample rate that works for the majority of the music you listen to and is neither too high nor low. Hope this video was of some help to you. Thanks for watching.